If you're looking to build your team, make sure you head on over to cheapmaddencoins.com for the cheapest prices, fast delivery, and 24-hour customer support. And make sure to use code WOLF for 10% off.
Hear ye, hear ye. Welcome to the Madden NFL 18 January title update video. Now, if that ain't the longest video title you've read all day, then I don't know what is. Now, I know I'm late on this video with this news, but something you guys need to learn about me, I am late to everything, even in real life, bro. If I have an appointment somewhere, I gotta be somewhere at a specific time, I'm always late. People know me as the guy that's always late. So like if they're throwing a party at 8, right? It's gonna start at 8 or 9. They're gonna tell me that I gotta be there by 7. You know, but I'm already on to these type of people, so I'm still late anyway. Anyway, let's talk about this information. I'm going to give you guys a little conspiracy theory, and I want you guys to tell me if it's possible or if it's not. That's just going to be something for you guys to decide. But after we go over what's new in this patch update. Now, if you hated Madden because of jukes, then you might want to come back because they fixed a lot of the juking in this game. And I don't mean like the juking itself, but being faked out by jukes. All right. So let's go ahead and read this real quick. To ensure Madden is the best game possible, title updates are deployed by the Madden development team to add features to the game after launch and to tune gameplay based on community feedback. Here is a detailed breakdown of what's included in the latest title update, now live in Madden NFL 18. What I just read right there would sound really dope if, who's that guy, that narrator guy, man? Not Samuel L. Jackson, the other guy, Morgan Freeman. I was gonna say, imagine Samuel L. Jackson narrating. He'd have to end it with mother, you know what I mean? But you know, you guys get what I'm saying. It would have sounded a lot better if it was Morgan Freeman reading that right there. Just pointing that out. Anyway, so substantial reduction to fake outs for user control defenders when defending ball carrier special moves. Now, that was a big problem. If I'm clicked on a user and someone jukes me, why should I pay a penalty for him juking if I'm the user? I didn't get faked out. I knew it was coming. So why am I gonna get trapped in an animation for such things? You know what I'm saying? So I'm glad they fixed that. Substantial means a lot. So it's not like the next one, slight. Substantial. Now, slight reduction to fakeouts for AI controlled defenders when defending ball carrier special moves. Now, I played one game since the patch, and it feels like it's a little bit easier to stop the run, all right? It feels just like a little bit easier. People really can't juke you as hard. I still do my powerful juke, my spin move, I mean, not the juke, but the actual spin move that I use, that hard one where I hold both triggers and press B, that one still works pretty good for me. I guess it just depends on the player and their rating as far as the moves. Anyway, addressed an issue that was causing some AI-controlled ball carriers to move slowly or not perform special moves. Now, I don't really recall even going through something like that, but I guess it was in the game. Tune to decrease range of width on kickoffs to address the kickoff exploit that could force returners out of bounds inside their own 5-yard line. Now, this is where the conspiracy theory falls in. I'm going to show you guys a video post-patch of the field. But what people are saying, and this is just a conspiracy theory, all right, it's just out there, is that the field is wider now. Now, what they mean by that is, if you ever played an opponent, they kick the ball, they'll kick it to the right side of the field, and then, you know, your tight end will pick up the ball. Well, they had an exploit where they could time the kicks right, you know, put the sliders where they need to go, and the ball would just fall like right inside the 5-yard line, and you'd be stuck there. Like your guy would like grab it and run out of bounds, or I don't know how it worked, because it very rarely, I don't even recall it happening to me, but there are people that they have it down, they mastered the kickoffs, and it was a good thing that they mastered it, because you know, kickoff returns, every other kickoff return was a TD, it seemed like, in Madden 18. Now let me see if I can pop up the video here on my screen. Now, here is some gameplay post-patch. You know, me thinking of the conspiracy theory of them widening the field to prevent those kickoffs. Is it possible that they did it? Now, I did read that one of the creators or someone that's on the Madden team said that it's fake news what people are saying, that the field is wider. But when they told me that, because I read it before I even played the game post-patch, and when I came to it, it just felt wider to me. You know what I mean? The field just felt like it was wider to me. But I need to know what you guys think. Are we just bums who think that the field is wider and it's really not? Or did they really stretch the field sideways? Or throwing C routes? I mean, C routes are gonna open up with a wider field, right? I'm just saying, do that. Let me know in the comments, man. Love you guys, man. Let me go ahead and just let this play out so you guys can see what you think. Does it feel wider to you? Does it look wider to you? To me, it does. To me, it feels like it's a little bit wider, man. I'm not going to lie. It feels a little bit wider to me. And that's me with Fournette running the ball down this guy's throat. Anyway, drop a like on the video. Subscribe to my channel for more content. I will check you guys out on the next one. Peace.